And now, performing the national anthem, graduating student, Hilda Placencia.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Congratulations, graduates! We did it!
To the Alliant Class of 2021, congratulations and thank you. Congratulations for reaching the culmination of your educational journey during one of the most difficult periods in modern history. And thank you for bringing our vision of an inclusive world empowered by Alliant alumni to life during one of the most trying times we faced as a community. This past year has served as a powerful lesson. Our world was brought to its knees by a pandemic, and our nation was brought to its knees once again by the forces of racism, xenophobia, and the protruding roots of American inequity. As individuals, we can't control the existence of the coronavirus, just as we can't control the existence of racism and injustice. But as a community, we can control the spread of both. It is through the decisions that we make as individuals each and every day that we show our shared values as a community, and it's through these values we set forth as a community to show our priorities as a society. Our experiences over this past year have served as a powerful lesson in control because we've seen that fostering public health and social justice is a shared responsibility. As a community that promotes scientific discovery, I know that many of you will expand on the lessons we've learned over this past year. Social science shows us that it's only by bringing our greatest obstacles into the light that we can begin to overcome them. In fact, a certain sector of social scientists is often pointing out that acknowledging we have a problem is the first step in solving it, or at least the first step on the road to recovery and healing. That is why, as we celebrate the academic and professional milestones you have achieved, we also celebrate the careers of impact you embark on this very day. We celebrate the quality of care you will provide to psychologists, therapists, and clinicians, the quality and equity you will bring to education as teachers, school counselors, school psychologists, administrators, and educators, the contributions that you will make to public safety as forensic and behavioral scientists, the justice you will seek as attorneys and advocates, and the innovations you will discover as data scientists and business leaders throughout the globe. As you go forth in your efforts to uphold a greater commitment to public health, social justice, safety in all forms, and equity at all levels of society, we wish you well. It's my greatest honor as the president of this university to say that we know with unwavering certainty and pride that you will be among those moving our community and society forward in these causes and many more to come. In fact, you should know that our expectations for the class of 2021 have been forever altered. We figure that if you could manage to complete your degree while handling the anxiety of a worldwide health and financial crisis, while working and studying from home, while becoming experts at the art of properly timing the mute functions in Zoom, and while taking on the additional role of parent, teacher, caregiver, spouse, friend, and good citizen, that you can easily solve many of the world's challenges in the coming years. We celebrate you for your dedication to education. We celebrate you for overcoming such great adversity on your journey to this virtual commencement stage. And we celebrate you for bringing our vision of an inclusive world empowered by Alliant alumni to life. To the Alliant class of 2021, congratulations and thank you. Congratulations as we celebrate your achievements, and thank you as we honor your impact yet to come.
Congratulations, Alliant class of 2021, on this incredible milestone. You have exceeded all expectations and overcome the challenges set forth not only by a rigorous academic program, but also by the rigors of life during a time of widespread uncertainty and unrest. Today, you are joining the family of Alliant alumni who are making an impact in their communities, reshaping their fields, and bringing our vision of an inclusive world empowered by Alliant alumni to life. There has never been a more vital time for you to translate your education into action. More than ever before, the world needs your expertise, your experience, and your advocacy. So as you cross this virtual stage and receive your degree, we congratulate you on the success you have achieved as Alliant students and look forward to the impact you will make as Alliant alumni. Congratulations to the Alliant class of 2021.
To our psychologists, therapists, and clinicians.
To our teachers, school counselors, school psychologists, administrators, and educators.
To our data scientists and business leaders.
To our forensic behavioral scientists.
To our attorneys and advocates.
To our California School of Professional Psychology graduates.
To our California School of Education graduates.
To our California School of Management and Leadership graduates.
To our California School of Forensic Studies graduates.
To our San Francisco Law School graduates.
To our class of 2021, congratulations.
To our class of 2021, congratulations.
To our class of 2021, congratulations.
To the class of 2021, congratulations.
To our class of 2021, congratulations.
Hello, graduating class of 2021. Let me ask you this. Do you think you're done? You're not. Don't get ahead of yourself. No, my friends, our journey has just yet begun. Sure, take this moment and recognize your success. You have accomplished a great deal. You were accepted into a competitive and challenging program. You have made sacrifices you never thought you would make. Maybe family time, meals, showers. You completed several hours of psychotherapy, grown in your knowledge of the field. Completed comprehensive exams, an oral exam, a novel, a dissertation, and completed an internship, some of which was done during a pandemic when you literally had to fight for toilet paper. For those of you who do not already know me, as I have been honored to work alongside several students with Alliant International University, doing international research and working alongside an internship, I am Mary Wells, a clinical psychology PsyD graduate with the Fresno campus. And thanks to the opportunities Alliant International University has afforded me, I am also a lieutenant in the United States Navy. But enough about me. Here you are now, the day you graduate from this program. How do you feel? Well, I can tell you, I am anxious. And for those of you who know me, you also know that is natural. You may be wondering, what is there to be nervous about? I will be honest. I worry about leaving that safety net of supervision, the guiding examples and words of professors, the wisdom of supervisors, and fear the loss of the camaraderie I have developed among my cohort mates who continue to lift me up and provide much needed consultation. However, I can confidently say that this program, our experiences in training, and our hard work have prepared us for this moment. Unfortunately, the buck does not stop here. We don't stop growing, becoming more culturally aware, learning, developing. If 2020 taught us nothing else, it certainly taught us that change is inevitable. And we must learn to be flexible, or as they say in the Navy and many other military branches, semper gumby. So as you prepare for licensure, getting board certified, and becoming a director or leader in your field, remember, if you survived graduate school during a pandemic, you can survive anything. This accomplishment is only one of many yet to come. It is crucial to remember that leaders do not develop on their own. We must thank our professors for those long, diligent hours in class and the time they spent marking up our papers and exams because, let's be honest, it's tedious. We must thank all of Alliant faculty, for how would we get safely to our vehicles after a late night of studying if not for security? How would we endure the rigorous research needed for our dissertation if not for our library staff? And how would we manage technical difficulties during COVID or tackle facility maintenance challenges if not for the individuals who manages those challenges for us? Finally, we must thank our family and friends who supported us during our breakdowns, wondered if we were still alive as we sorely neglected them during our education, and more importantly, supported us being our constant cheerleaders. My husband, who was my endless inspiration in this program, would always tell me, "It's amazing what you can accomplish when failure is not an option." Though these words give me strength, I will say I indeed have failed over and over and over again. But it was what I learned when I stood back up, dusted myself off, and even maybe wiped away a few tears. In those moments, I recognized my resilience, grew more knowledgeable, and became a better version of myself. I am sure you all have had similar moments in the past few years, but you got back up, and that is how you made it to your graduation day. Keep this in mind as you pursue your next endeavor. It was Eric Erickson who said, "The more you know yourself, the more patience you have for what you see in others." So never stop that internal exploration. And Sigmund Freud, who said, "One day, in retrospect, the years of struggle will strike you as the most beautiful." Do not be afraid of criticism and failure, because it's within failure we learn, and where success develops its battle strategy. As I said, you are not done. There are still major research projects waiting to be revealed, new programs that need to be developed, new psychological assessments that will be titled with your last name, and many patients whose lives will forever be changed in one way or another because of you. So, with my final words, let me ask you this. Fellow clinicians, doctors, how does that make you feel? Thank you, and good luck to you all on your next adventures.
Good evening, class of 2021. Some of you know me, but most of you probably don't, so let me introduce myself real quick. My name is Ted Albrecht, and I'm graduating from the Los Angeles Clinical PsyD program. I love chips and salsa, the movie Gladiator, and The Color Green. Now that you know everything about me, I also had the pleasure of serving as system-wide student treasurer for about 2 years. And during that time, I had the luxury of meeting some of you from other campuses. From corresponding and interacting with students across campuses, I can confidently say that each and every person I met was an amazing person with much to offer the world. And for that reason, I'm excited to be providing this speech today to you, my colleagues. For myself, and probably for many of you, that this process has not been unlike the process of learning how to ride a bike. For those of us who maybe could never learn or didn't have the opportunity to do so, I welcome the imagination of any event you feel helped you develop a stronger sense of resilience during this recounting. I, as many of us did, started off extremely excited and ecstatic when that first bike made its way home. Whether it showed up magically from some mythical jolly man or a real person, I invite you to remember that feeling in the moment of receiving your first bike. If you're like me, you probably couldn't wait to take that thing out for a spin. This was very similar to our initial entrance into grad school, having that exuberance to get out and do something we have absolutely no idea how to do, but relishing in the fact that we had two extra wheels in the back that made it nearly impossible to fall over. So much fun and very safe. But there comes a time for every kid to take away those training wheels, and again, if you're anything like me, that was terrifying. I relate this to our seeking for reassurance from our highly esteemed mentors, role models, and supervisors in the field. It's necessary reassurance, and it keeps us upright and stable during the process. Yet at many points, and usually at the point when I was worried and looked back to see if my dad was still there, that's when, straight into the gutter. But the funny thing is, while I know that I was terrified to try, and I know that I fell many times, I don't even remember any times that I fell. I only remember that first time when I looked back and my dad wasn't there. That sense of accomplishment, pride, and freedom. Most of us fell many times during this grad school process, and if you're like me, you spent some time scraping the pavement. But it's time now to experience that pride, to know that we are chugging on ahead without the need for that steady-handed guidance, and to embrace the simultaneous fear and excitement of moving on independently to a new job, private practice, post-grad fellowship, wherever you might be headed. I also encourage you all to channel Dr. Thomas Gabriel Wayne. Dr. Wayne, who might be better known to you as Batman's dad, asked his son, "Bruce, why do we fall?" so that we can pick ourselves back up again. I share this quote to emphasize the resilience we've developed from learning to ride a bike and make it through to completion of an arduous graduate school journey. It has also been my experience that many of us in this field from all across all campuses have an innate desire to help better the world. Some may have even ventured into the territory of having a hero complex like me. This field has introduced me to some of the most profoundly well-meaning, nurturing, hardworking, and intelligent people I've ever met, and luckily in the last year we've added masks to the mix. So what's more superhero-esque than that? But my purpose with this sidetrack into the superhero universe is not to compare us to our favorite superheroes, rather it's to humbly remind everybody that we are human. We are not superheroes. Some of you might be thinking right now, yeah, I know I'm not a superhero, that's ridiculous. Some of you might be thinking, this is extremely cheesy and cliche. Some of you may be thinking, who's Batman? But no matter what you're thinking right now or every day behind that mask that you wear to work, we as humans in this field have a unique opportunity to make positive changes in the world. We worked exceptionally hard to get to where we are now, graduating from programs that challenged us both as people and as professionals. To quote Rachel Dawes in Batman Begins, it's not who we are underneath, but what we do that defines us. And friends, colleagues, strangers from other campuses, we're in the best well-doing field there is. And we can all do that without a cape, without the ability to fly, and without a super fancy machine that turns us into an unbelievably powerful ant. We can do it as ourselves, thanks to our roles as humans and our newfound titles of master or doctor. So I hope you all throw away the training wheels and take off the mask and connect with and help improve the lives of as many people as we humanly can. Congratulations, class of 2021.
I never thought that I'd be addressing the class of 2021 from the comfort of my living room. But despite that, it's still a tremendous honor to be able to speak to colleagues and classmates who helped me to remain invigorated and energized by psychology in all of its forms, despite the hardships we know this field can involve. At the time of this recording, it was a particularly tough week for me while on internship. One of those weeks that really tests your resolve and your inner strength. And while processing the intensity of this week, I was struck by the idea that despite any hardships we may face, we continue to show up as students and trainees in service of others. And as students of Alliant, we really grew our enthusiasm for psychology. We spent countless hours researching and writing, participating in therapy and assessment, and devoted our time to better understanding ourselves as well as those around us. While these experiences shaped us and inspired us, they were not always easy. There were long nights writing our dissertations where we heavily considered a career change. And there were meetings with clients and patients who challenged us and caused us to rethink our capabilities as effective clinicians. Despite these instances, we knew that we loved the work, and something pushed us to keep going. That's been my experience while on internship. For the past several months, I've been at University of Vermont Medical Center in their medical psychology department. And the work has been hard. And prior to matching with them, I knew very little about the medical field and often felt nervous or incompetent in my own capabilities. But despite being on internship for some time now, instances of the imposter phenomenon continue to creep up for me, and I think that they always will. One of these moments occurred while providing psychotherapy to a 57-year-old woman. She came to our department for treatment of depression following a breast cancer diagnosis. We began our work together using a very structured cognitive behavioral framework, and eventually we veered away from that. It became clear that she didn't want structure, and it became even clearer to me that that wasn't in my natural therapeutic style. In my mind, our less structured and more open approach seemed to be working for her, seemed to be effective. Recently, though, she mentioned to me that she's been angry and annoyed with me, angry that she continues to experience depression despite how long we've been working together. Hearing those words that she was angry and annoyed just completely crushed me. They caused me to question my abilities and doubt the work that she and I had done together thus far. And it made me feel nervous to see her again and feel timid as a clinician. A few days after that, our department hosted their annual lecture series. The keynote speaker discussed things like anxiety and fear in medical settings. And during a trying week in which I was feeling really down and demoralized, something he said really stuck with me. He said, "Courage is having fear, but deciding to do it anyway." As students of psychology, of course we've had many fears, but we've decided to move forward regardless. We've had fears regarding our clinical skills and what our futures would look like as practicing psychologists. But despite these fears, we've remembered that we've loved the work, and we remembered what motivated us to keep going. Fortunately for me, and for all of us, Alliant has been the institution where we found what motivates us to keep going. Whether it was therapy, assessment, research, or writing, we've remained courageous, and will continue to tap into that courage as we transition now from students to professionals. And throughout our careers. As we graduate today with our formal education behind us, let us celebrate the courage that has sustained us thus far, and the courage that will keep us going for many years to come. Class of 2021, congratulations. Thank you.
Thank you. Kaur, and I'm a graduate from the Alliant Couple and Family Therapy Program. It's my privilege and honor to address you all here today. I'd like to start with a quote. In The Prisoner of Azkaban, Dumbledore, the headmaster of Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry, said, "Happiness can be found even in the darkest of times, if only one remembers to turn on the light." The first time I heard this quote, I was in elementary school, and I scribbled down the words into my journal because they touched something deep inside of me that I did not fully understand yet. These words have stuck with me and cradled me through middle school when I felt like an outcast, through my first high school breakup, through a school shooting in college, through moments of feeling lost and questioning my life's direction in my early 20s, through a global pandemic, and many other moments of big and small darkness. These words stuck with me so much that I decided to end my final undergraduate paper with them in 2016 and begin this speech with them here with you today. But this speech is not about Dumbledore or even Harry Potter. This speech is a celebration of our resilience. This speech is an ode to the many ways that we, class of 2021, have continued to turn on the lights, even in the darkest of times. The first word that comes to my mind when I think of this year's graduating class is resilience. Resilience is the quality that enables us to bend but not break in the face of adversity. Resilient people adapt to changing situations, overcome hardship, and grow stronger from it. It's no secret that this past year has been challenging to say the least, and our class has had to find a level of strength, creativity, humility, and hope that we did not even know existed within us. For a moment, I want us to travel back in time to when we first started here at Alliant. To me, it felt like standing at the base of a mountain, looking up at the top, unsure of what the journey to the summit would entail. We couldn't see the twists and turns that we would encounter along the way. As we set off on our trip, we had expectations, fears, excitement, and a whole lot of unknowns. The trip to the top seemed so monumental that we just started putting one foot in front of the other. And step by step, class by class, assignment by assignment, we began to catch our stride. Along the way, we encountered terrain that we had never expected. Zoom classes, social isolation, civil unrest, a global pandemic, pain, crying into our textbooks, questioning our decisions to go back to school. Okay, maybe that last one was just me, but my point is that there were many moments where things got dark and the path ahead seemed unknown. But in these moments, somehow we lifted ourselves up, found our strength, and persevered. To keep moving forward, we had to learn how to find sources of light. Our professors and faculty became our headlamps, illuminating our path forward and giving us hope. Our peers, friends, and family became little bonfires along our journey that kept us warm in the coldest of moments with their love, support, and all the little I know you cans along the way. And as such, we kept trekking. Now, here we are, looking down from the top at all the steps we took to get here. And somehow, the view feels even sweeter than expected. It's not what we anticipated, but somehow the challenges of the hike make these final moments feel even more special, even more deserved. It was not easy, but we made it. Can we pause for just a moment and take in the view? As we stand here at the top, I want to honor the many expressions of resilience it has taken each and every one of us to get here. I cannot express the depth of my gratitude that exists for all who made this possible for our class. Thank you to our professors, faculty, and staff for guiding us through the many unknowns that this year has thrown at us. Thank you for doing everything in your power to help us feel safe, regardless of our unique backgrounds, race, gender, political beliefs, religions, hometowns, socioeconomic statuses, etc. And thank you for being open to feedback and course correction in moments where growth was necessary. Thank you for keeping our programs moving and putting countless hours into learning completely new virtual systems and adapting in so many ways that we probably don't even see. And thank you to the folks in the background who make things run smoothly and often go without recognition. I'm looking at UIT. You're the real MVPs. Thank you to our partners, parents, kids, siblings, pets, and families of choice for supporting us throughout this process. I know it has not always been easy, and you've had to step up in big ways to make this possible for us to go out and achieve our goals. Thank you for believing in our dreams. Your contributions do not go unnoticed. Even if we snap at you during finals week or don't talk to you for days on end while drowning in our textbooks. And most importantly, thank you to the amazingly resilient, totally badass class of 2021. Personally, I have leaned on many of you in moments of breakdowns and breakthroughs. And I know that we all have those classmates who have offered us unwavering support, even in the toughest of times. It has been so hard being apart from you physically this past year, and I miss seeing your faces on campus. But our connections have persevered, and now we know that we will continue to support one another across distance and time, even when our school time memories begin to fade. My hope is that each of you will go out into the world and impact it as you have impacted me, as a source of inspiration and hope. We're not born with a fixed amount of resilience. It's a muscle we can flex and grow, and by God have we learned how to do that this year. But now we have strength that we can draw on when we need it. The hard days have made us realize how strong we really are and how much we can overcome. And they make the bright days feel even brighter, like today. Taking this next step on our journey, there will be easy, beautiful, blissful days. And there will be dark ones too. On the hard days, we have permission to break down and feel our feelings. This is so important. And we also have the choice to look for the lessons. Flex our muscles, notice the gifts of breaking apart to come back together more resilient than when we started. The spotlight is now on us. How can we use the strength and resilience we've built to go out into the world and, as Dumbledore would say, turn on the lights? This is our time, and I'm so, so proud of all of you. Thank you.
Have you ever thought about jumping out of a plane without a parachute? Or discovering once you have jumped, your parachute doesn't open? Yeah, me either. But that is probably what you felt like when you started on this milestone of your college journey. Sometimes the path we chose is not the easiest one. Those hard moments are the ones that will shape you, mold you, and change you. Remember, this whole journey started with a dream to create change. A dream to change who you were and where you wanted to end up. Meeting a milestone at any point in our lives is an accomplishment. Meeting that milestone during a global pandemic speaks a lot about your character, drive, and perseverance. We are all fighting the same battle, even if on different battlegrounds. Yet here we are, some at the end of their journey, some moving from one stepping stone to another. All eager to change lives and make a difference in this ever-changing world. I will ask that you all close your eyes. Yes, I know this seems silly doing this in our living rooms, but I want you to take in this moment, this very moment right now. When your eyes are closed, think about what you feel right now. Relief? Happiness? Accomplished? Try and look back to the first day you thought, hey, let's do this college thing. Some just fresh out of high school. Some even way out of high school. Some, like myself, way out of high school. We sent in the application and waited for approval. Next, think back to that first day, pulling into a parking lot or opening your laptop to start your new journey. There was so much crazy excitement for some and so much nerves for others. Think about halfway through your program when you thought about throwing in the towel, and those same people around you right now kept throwing it back and telling you not to quit. We have all been there. Then think about as your program started to come to an end and a pandemic hit. I'm sure many of you really wanted to throw in the towel, and this time, Alliant was there throwing it back at you, telling you not to quit. We have your back. We're here for you. We will get through this. Some finished their program at the beginning of the pandemic, already 12 months ago, and were absolutely devastated they were not able to celebrate that accomplishment with their family, friends, and teachers. That day has now come to celebrate you and all you have achieved. As your eyes are closed, think about those you are around you right now, still celebrating you, supporting you, and encouraging you. With their support, you have now changed your own legacy. You will now become an influencer to those around you. I started this journey to change my own family tree, to leave a legacy behind that those after me would strive to achieve as well. There are so many things we can't take with us when our time here is complete, like that 1970 Super B. However, the legacy you have created will stay for a lifetime, forever planted on your family tree. I am an influencer to 6 branches on my own family tree that I have strived to set high standards for. Without them giving me the strength, courage, and drive to complete this goal, I would have never made it this far. Even if done in the unconventional way, it was done. There is no time frame on achievement. I encourage you to look around you and thank that person or people that helped you get here today. Thank them for all they have done for you, for the encouraging words, the nagging, and checking up on you to see how much longer till you have your degree. The journey definitely doesn't end here. It is truly just the beginning. Thankfully, all our parachutes have opened. Be the change you want to see in this world. Instead of asking your neighbor what they can do for you, ask what you can do for them. You are now an influencer for generations to come, an influencer for greatness, and an influencer that dreams do come true. Be the influencer in your family tree that will mold generations to come. Be the legacy you want to see passed down. You are no longer a dreamer, you are an achiever. Be proud of your accomplishment and that you chose to stick with it even through the hard times. Keep the mindset that you can achieve anything you put your mind to. Go out into the world and encourage others to change their legacy just as you have yours. It has been such an honor to be among so many accomplished achievers. I wish nothing but the best for each of you. I congratulate you on your accomplishment and the legacy you have created. Keep achieving greatness. You are the change this world needs.
We are delighted to continue Alliant's tradition of Voices of Diversity in our 2021 commencement program. Graduates will recite our mission statement in their native languages.
Alliant's mission is to prepare students for professional careers of service and leadership, and promote the discovery and application of knowledge to improve the lives of people in diverse cultures and communities around the world.
La misión de Alliant es preparar estudiantes en carreras de servicios profesionales y de liderazgo y desarrollar y promover el conocimiento para mejorar la vida de personas en diversas culturas y comunidades alrededor del mundo.
Ang layunan ng Alliant ay upang maihanda ang bawat mag-aaral nito sa profesional na pagsaservisyo at pampupuno. Ang paglusong sa pagtuklas at paggamit ng mga kaalaman upang mapag-unlad ang buhay ng mga tao sa iba't ibang kultura at komunidad sa buong mundo.
مهمة جامعة Alliant International University إعداد الطلاب ليكونوا قادة في المهن المتخصصة في الخدمات وتأهيلهم لاكتشاف المعرفة وتطبيقها لتحسين حياة الناس في ثقافات ومجتمعات متنوعة حول العالم.
Sứ mệnh của Alliant là chuẩn bị cho sinh viên sự nghiệp phục vụ và lãnh đạo chuyên nghiệp, đồng thời thúc đẩy việc khám phá và ứng dụng kiến thức để cải thiện cuộc sống của mọi người trong các nền văn hóa và cộng đồng đa dạng trên thế giới.
Hello, this is the Alliant mission statement in Russian language. Миссия Alliant – подготовить студентов к профессиональной карьере в сфере обслуживания и лидерства, а также способствовать открытию и применению знаний для улучшения жизни людей в различных культурах и сообществах по всему миру. Thank you.
Alliant-ի նշանակը կերտսն է պատրաստել ուսանողներին մասնագիտական ծառայության կարիրաներին և առաջնորդության համար և օժանդակել հայնագործությունը և գիտելիքի կիրառումը բարելավելու մարդու կյանքը տարբեր մշակույթներում և աշխարհի բոլոր համայնքներում.
La mission d'Alliant est de préparer les étudiants à des carrières professionnelles dans les domaines du service et du leadership et de promouvoir la découverte et la mise en application du savoir afin d'améliorer la vie de personnes issues de cultures et de communautés diverses à travers le monde.
President Vaughn, it is my pleasure to present to you the graduating class of 2021 of Alliant International University.
By the power vested in me by the Board of Trustees and Board of Directors of Alliant International University and the State of California, I hereby confer the degrees of Bachelor of Science, Master of Arts in Education, Master of Science, Doctor of Business Administration, Doctor of Education, Doctor of Psychology, Doctor of Philosophy, Juris Doctorate, with all the rights and privileges pertaining to each. Graduates, it is my pleasure to congratulate you on this important accomplishment. You may now move your tassel to the left. Congratulations, class of 2021.
San Francisco Law School.
The California School of Forensic Studies.
California School of Management and Leadership.
Thank you.
California School of Professional Psychology graduates.
Congratulations to all of you, the Alliant International University graduates of 2021. On behalf of the faculty, the staff, and the entire university, congratulations, and let me be the first to welcome you to the Alliant International University alumni community. We send you forth to fulfill Alliant's vision of an inclusive world empowered by Alliant alumni.